Now, if we see the help for this matrix function, I just note this now, line number 24, okay. So I put a question mark and I've written matrix over there. It means that if whenever I'm writing such a thing, it will give me the help for that matrix function, okay. So let me run this and you see that I have this help thing, you know, coming over here. There is an R documentation. And it kind of says that this matrix is a function, okay, so which takes the first argument as data, and that's what we have given, okay, the data. The next argument is the number of rows, so that's what we have given, number of rows. The third argument is the number of columns, okay, and that's what we have given, number of columns. The fourth one is by row, and by default it's set as false, means see, if I do not specify by row is equal to true, then what happens is that the filling starts column wise. The filling happens column wise, okay. So because by default it's set as false, okay. And the last one, I got the dimension names. So basically what I can do, I can put all these things together over here. You see that I am rewriting these lines of code again. I started with matrix. I've given a vector, okay, which are going to be the elements in my matrix. The number of rows is equal to 2, n call is equal to 2, pi row equals 2. Now, note here that you can, when you're trying to write write true or false in R, you can either write TRUE with all capital letters, or you can just simply write a T, capital T. Okay, it works both the ways. And then I can give the dim names, means dimension names, means I can utilize this argument to give these names. Okay, so basically I need to put in a structure called list, and then I need to give these two vectors, one vector for row names and the other vector called column names. Now list is another data structure that can bind two vectors together. So it does other lot of work as well. But for now, just understand it just binds two vector together.